This video is going to be about the rectangular coordinate system. Sometimes it's called the Cartesian coordinate plane. The rectangular coordinate system is actually, it is a plane. It is made up of a horizontal number line, which is called the x-axis, and a vertical number line, which is called the y-axis. Now, these are number lines, which means that if I could write it without it getting so cluttered, this would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. To the left would be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. For the vertical one, it would go up in a positive direction, so that would be 1, 2, 3, 4. Down would be negative, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. And what this does is it forms a grid so that every location can be talked about by where the point is relative to the x-axis and the y-axis. If you've ever played the game Battleship, then you know that you had two coordinates to name a location. It's just that one of them was probably a letter and one of them was a number. But in our system, it is number and number. Every point has an ordered pair of numbers that names it. The ordered pair is put in parentheses. The X number comes first and the Y number comes second. And it is called, they are called coordinates of the point. The first point is the x coordinate, and the second point is the y coordinate, and they must come in that order. So every point, let's say for instance this point, it would be named with an ordered pair or with the coordinates 3, 2, because from where everything originates, it's called the origin, from the origin in the x direction you'd go to 3, in the y direction you'd go to 2. It's like going 3 blocks one way and 2 blocks the other. What is so important is that you remember x comes first and y comes second. All right, so now I'm going to practice with you a little bit naming points on the coordinate plane. I'm going to switch to red because I think it will show up clearly. Let's suppose we're talking about this location. The ordered pair that names that point is 4, 3, because from the origin you would go 4 in the x direction, you would go 3 in the y direction. This point down here would be named 2, because you'd have to go 2 in the x direction, but you have to go down 3, so in the y direction it's labeled negative 3. How about this point? In the x direction you would go negative 1. You're always starting at the origin to determine this. And then in a y direction you'd go up, that's 4, that's 5, that's 6. So it is the point negative 1, 6. Finally, how about this point right here? To name it, you start at the origin. In the x direction, you would go negative 1. In the y direction, you would go negative 3. Sometimes you're on one of the axes. Let's suppose we're at this point. From the origin, to name how to get to that point, whoops, did it again, opened a program. You would go 2 to the right, so it's 2 for the x coordinate. You don't go up or down, so the y coordinate is 0. That is the point 2, 0. This point, from the origin, you don't go right or left, so the x coordinate is 0. The y coordinate is 4. Right here, in the x direction you go negative 3, in the y direction you don't go up or down, so it is negative 3, 0. What about the origin? What would the ordered pair for the origin be? Well, you don't move to the right, left, up, or down. So the origin is the point 0, 0. Let me also mention that you can see that these two intersecting axes break the plane into four regions, and they are named. This is quadrant 1. This is quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and quadrant 4. So they always start in the upper right-hand quadrant where everything is positive, and it goes counterclockwise, and those are called quadrants. And that's kind of hard to read, but the color's pretty. Anyway, this gives you some idea about naming ordered pairs or coordinates and quadrants. So now let's look at some of our exercises. Problem number 1. Plot the ordered pair 1, 1. State in which quadrant or on which axis the point lies. Well, you will click that location with your mouse, and if you're supposed to go to 1, 1, that's positive 1 in the x direction, positive 1 in the y direction. So you will move it 1, 1, and drop it right there. That is the point 1, 1. Which quadrant is it in? Well, this is quadrant 1, 2, 3, 4. So it lies in quadrant 1. Okay, let's look at our next one. Find the x and y coordinates of point B. All right, point B is there. Well, here's the ordered pair from the origin. In the x direction, you don't need to go right or left, so it is 0. But to get to point B, although you didn't need to go right or left, you do have to go on the y direction up positive 2. So it is the point 0, 2. When you type that in, you need to make sure you put parentheses 0, a comma, 2, close parentheses. Let's look at number 3. Okay. Here is point C. To name its ordered pair, start at the origin. How do I need to move in the x direction to travel to point C? I need 1, 2, 3, 4 in the x direction, positive. And in the y direction, up 1, 2, 3, which is also positive. So it is the point 4, 3. Let's look at a few more. Find the coordinates of point E. Okay, point E. Starting at the origin, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the x direction to the left. So that's negative 5. Then I need to go 1, 2, 3, 4 down. So that's negative 4. That's the point negative 5, negative 4. It is understood among math people that it will always be x direction, y direction, starting at the origin. Next, point B, the ordered pair from the origin to go, do you need to go right or left? No, so you move 0. To go vertically, I need to go down 2, which is a negative direction, so it is 0, negative 2. And finally, last point, give the coordinates of point C. All right, from the origin, you would have to move to the right to get to the right 1 to get in line with point C. So in the x direction, 1. In the y direction, up 2. It is the point 1, 2. The x and the y. From the origin, in the x direction, you move 1. In the y direction, you move 2. 1 positive, 2 positive, puts you into the first quadrant. So practice now on your homework, recognizing the locations, the coordinates of points in the rectangular coordinate plane.